रेडियो खांची 90.4 एफएम पर प्रसारित किए जाने वाले विषय वस्तु का सारा क्रेडिट प्रस्तुतकर्ता को दिया जाता है। हमारा मकसद है समाज में ज्ञान एवं सकारात्मकता को आगे बढ़ाना।
वेलकम टू रेडियो खांची 90.4 एफएम, हम सबका रेडियो। आई एम डॉक्टर सुनीता ठाकुर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, डोरंडा कॉलेज, रांची यूनिवर्सिटी, रांची। Today's topic is chromosome banding. It is related for botany students of postgraduate semester 2 and undergraduate botany honors semester 3. Reference books are Cytogenetics and Advanced Study by P.K. Gupta, Chromosome Banding by A.T. Sumner. In the previous section, we learned about basic of chromosome banding and quinacrine banding. In this part, we shall deal with following topics: G banding, C banding, R banding, N banding, as well as chromosome banding. We shall also discuss the importance as well as applications of chromosome banding. Now, coming to the topic. G banding or GIMSA banding. In cytogenetics, more frequent used technique is G banding. It produces a visible karyotype by staining condensed chromosomes. It was first used for human chromosome by Sumner et al. In 1971. GIMSA is a non-fluorescent staining. In G banding, chromosome need pre-treatment. Usually proteolytic enzyme like trypsin or protease is used for pre-treatment for denaturation of protein. Then chromosome treated with renatural by thiazine and eosine. Then treated with GIMSA stain. GIMSA is a mixture of methylene, azure plus methylene violet plus methylene blue plus eosine. G banding is also called GTG banding, means G banding by trypsin with GIMSA. G banding also produce same banding pattern like Q banding along the length of chromosomes. GIMSA stain has more affinity for adenine thymine rich region than guanine cytosine rich region. So, adenine thymine rich sequences stain darker while guanine cytosine rich sequences stain lighter. C banding, it is also called centromeric heterochromatin staining. This technique was first used by Pardue and Gall. In this technique, pre-treatment before GIMSA staining with alkali is necessary. So, C banding is also called CBG staining. C banding base with GIMSA. Each chromosome possesses a different degree of constitutive heterochromatin, which enable the identifications centromeric heterochromatin and distal part of Y chromosome because they contain highly repetitive DNA sequences. C banding technique is very useful for identification of different regions of heterochromatin zone present on chromosomes. R banding, it is also called reverse chromosome banding. By use of this technique, the band pattern produced in chromosome is reversed to the band produced by G banding and Q banding. Example, the dark band at adenine thymine rich region observed in G banding technique appear light in R banding and vice versa. R banding is opposite to C banding. It stains non-centromeric region. N-banding or N-O-R banding. first described by Matsui and Sasaki in 1973. In this chromosome banding, chromosome first air-dried, then treated with 5% trichloroacetic acid at 95 degree Celsius for 30 minutes, then treated with 0.1 NaCl at 60 degree Celsius for 30 minutes. Banding pattern are easily seen in structural non-histone protein linked to nuclear organizer region. N bands are generally located at the secondary constriction, satellites, centrosomes, telomeres, and other heterochromatin zone. N bands represent certain structural non-histone protein specifically linked to the nuclear organizer region of the eukaryotic chromosomes. N banding patterns differ in the chromosomes of different species. Now we will discuss about chromosome painting. It is a very advanced chromosome painting technique. Colorful chromosome images are created by treating chromosomes sprayed with fluorescently labeled DNA fragments. In this technique, isolation of DNA fragment is very essential. Then it coupled with fluorescence in situ hybridization, FISH, for identification of chromosome. Now, importance and applications of chromosome banding. The most important application of banding is the identification of individual chromosomes. G-banding is also valuable for the identification of chromosome arrangement called karyotype. It determines karyotype of different species and establishes relationship between them. It is very important in the course of evolution. It identifies specific gene locus present in chromosomes. Chromosome banding technique is very useful for determining heterochromatin and euchromatin region present on chromosomes. Chromosomal banding technique is very useful to study of primary chromosome structural changes. G-banding has been utilized extensively to detect genetic alterations in bone tumors. Q-banding technique is mostly used to identify human and mice chromosomes. Majority of chromosomal abnormalities observed in aborted fetus evaluated by G-banding. By example, trisomy, polyploid, sex chromosome monosomy, etc. It is very useful for identify genetic disease through like photographic representation of the entire chromosomes. It also identifies the position of centromere and telomeres in chromosomes. Chromosome banding is also identify types of cancer present in human. Conclusions. Chromosome banding technique is a boon in the field of cytogenetic researches. It identifies and determine, evaluate various types of genetic and non-genetic disease caused by chromosome abnormalities. Banding pattern in human, chimpanzee, and gorilla. Banding pattern in human, chimpanzee, gorilla, and orangutans have indicated that the evolutionary relationship between human and chimpanzee is closer than that between human and gorilla. It is also indicate that human have more distant evolutionary relationship with orangutans. Thank you.
हम सबका रेडियो रेडियो खांची 90.4 FM रांची. अगर आप हमारे विश्वविद्यालय के टीचर्स के द्वारा खास विषय पर लेक्चर सुनना चाहते हैं तो शाम 6 बजे से आपके लिए रेडियो खांची 90.4 FM पर विशेष रेडियो क्लासेस का आयोजन किया जा रहा है। सुनना ना भूलिए शाम 6 बजे से रेडियो खांची 90.4 FM, हम सब करेंगे।